Hello, YouTubers. This is the Noobifier. PTU 312 India had some changes done to the insurance claim time and cost at the ASOP terminals. The original links are in the description as usual. The posts have over 550 replies, and that stuff's climbing. Way to go, Spectrum. Didn't bother to check, but I'm sure it's on Reddit too. All this was said to be done for balance, and here's what you need to know. On the 13th of December 2020, Ulf posted in the morning that they would be elongating the claim time for both expedited and standard. That would include a change in price as well. This was being done to combat a rash of behavior in the PU, where players would rather self-destruct than repair, reload, or try to fly to safety. It's clear that they want us to value the price of our ship, and to do that, the plan is to make it pinch more. They're also planning to rebalance some of the payouts to successfully completing missions. All this is said to get us to a step closer to actual values that we will eventually have as we get closer to live release. I'm going to present two opinions, and I'm going to try to keep my personal thoughts out of this, because I really don't have an opinion. These are some pros and cons that I found while researching, and I will end on a list of examples to these changes. The pros were, as I said, to incentivize players to value their ships, to test a balance closer to where the values might be in the future, and it's actually pretty easy to see what CIG's motivations are. The community, on the other hand, as usual, had its own wealth of opinions and listed some concerns about the following cons. The fact that I'm presenting more cons does not mean that I'm trying to sway my opinion or yours. Some argued that until the 30Ks and other unavoidable issues are addressed and stability is reliable, that this is a horrible time to add these types of changes. The current time sink is low, which allows players to reclaim and be up again in about 4 or so minutes. If that was extended to 12 hours, the general consensus was that the players may need to choose a second ship, a different ship, or might just say peace out, Alt-F4, and do something else. Those people were concerned that if the point of the PTU was to test the PTU, that these changes may make even fewer people interested in testing. And others pointed out that if the rearm and repair system worked better, fewer people would be self-destructing. I found this interesting that there was a similar theme for those who would be seen as PvP bounty hunters and those who would wish to be left alone. As much as it makes it harder for the killer to recover from being killed, it also punishes the miner or cargo runner who didn't bother to find an escort. It's always been the end state from a PvP perspective that if you don't want to be killed, hire friends to fly with you. However, as was said, with a limit of 50 players and the aforementioned stability issues, some said that it was impractical to always link up as intended, thus becoming a second argument against the changes being applied now. So that's the what, how, and the reaction. But I really want you to comment in the comments with your comments. The point of a community like this is that feedback. As promised, I'm going to round out with a couple examples from the database, and this is based on patch 312 India, and of course, all of that is subject to change. Some smaller ships actually have less time to wait and cost less to expedite. Some others hurt a lot more. So your Avengers, your Argos, Mustangs, Auroras, and most buggies are less time expensive and cost less to expedite. On average, half as long. Connie's went from 20 minutes to 45 and used to loosely cost about $1,000, but now cost $10,000. The Limited Phoenix is even more and more expensive. The Lancers went from 15 minutes to just over 30, and they are 6 times more expensive to expedite. The Caterpillar now takes an hour to claim, or you can pay $9,000 and get it back in 12 minutes. The Hammerhead, the Carrack, and the 600 are all close to the same, about 2.5 hours, or 30 minutes if you pay 22,000 UEC. And my last example is the 890 Jump, which went from 1 hour to 4, unless you pay 40,000 UEC, and then you still need to wait an hour. So, there's the info. Do you care? Would this matter? Will this make you log out and do something else? Thank you very much for spending your time with me. Fly safe, and I'll see you in the verse.